grew up in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and then I eventually moved up to Northern Kentucky when I was 10 years old so my mom could take care of my grandpa. And when we used to come up and visit them, there was a lot of pictures and a lot of happiness going on around.
I pretty much lived in Edgewood, Kentucky my whole life. Most of my life revolved around cheerleading growing up. My mom was always my cheerleading coach, and my sister was involved, and when we cheered for Raiders, my dad coached football, so it was always a family affair.
I played football, and I played for a long time. I started when I was like 6 or so, and stopped when I was 18. It's about my childhood, really. I played a lot of sports.
I've always been a daddy's girl, definitely. He obviously doesn't have any boys. It's just me and my sister, and instead of me and him doing girly things, he was taking me to Bengals games when I was 5, and that's part of Jeff and I's connection is we both love football, we both love sports, and we have that in common for sure, and I think it all comes from my dad.
Amanda and I hit it off really well when we first reunited again because we met each other in middle school, and I don't know, she's just really easygoing, easy to get along with, likes to laugh. She's obviously beautiful. We have a lot of the same interests.
I think he's a ball of energy. He's definitely the one out of his friends that makes everyone laugh and says silly things. And he definitely can put a smile on anyone's face, which is part of the reason I fell in love with him, is just he could always make me laugh. He has a huge heart, and he definitely wants to take care of everyone. And, you know, he's a people pleaser. I believe it was September 2010. We were at Brothers in Newport.
And all our friends were just at Brothers, and we were talking with them. And then I saw her the next night again, and I was like, man, this is weird.
We exchanged numbers, and we made plans to watch Sunday Night Football the next night. And he came over to my house, and we watched football. And I think we were together almost every day after that from there. So the rest is history, you could say.
We have a goofy personality when we're with each other that's similar to each other. It's goofy, but I'd say that's one of her things that I enjoy the most. She makes me laugh.
We actually, one of the, probably our official first date was, he took me to a wedding, and it was at the Grand where our wedding is going to be. So he took me as his guest to one of his friend's weddings, and that probably was our first official date.
We get along really well, and it's just how fast and how quick we got along really well, and we have the same interests, so it's like, I don't know, it was a combination of a lot of things. And then we bought the house last year, and I was like, man, you know, it just seems like it's time to go ahead and go to the next level. So I was really happy, and I still am really happy, so it was like, why not, you know?
I think very soon into our relationship, I think that we both knew. I mean, I know that even after not dating for very long, we said I love you to each other, probably only after like a month or two. To me, it was obvious that I'd never felt that way about anyone before, and I think people always think previously they know what love is and that they've been in love, and it definitely was different with Jeff, and I just knew between our friends loving each other and getting along, our families, them loving Jeff and me loving his family and having the same interest, and the combination of that and the way we felt about each other, I would say within the first like month of us dating that I think that we both knew that it was something big.
Well, before I got the ring, I went and asked Amanda's dad. That was probably the most nervous part, really, because I went and asked him, and I told him, I was like, I plan on doing it when we go on vacation with your family and everything, and he said, sounds great. And me and my mom went to get the ring. After that, I had it set up, and I told her mom and dad knew about it, and they said they wouldn't tell nobody, and we were driving down there the whole way.
And we had driven through the night, and we were grumpy and miserably tired.
And then we got there, and I was kept trying to get her to go walk on the beach with me. I was like, let's go just take a walk, you know? And she's like, no, I don't want to. I'm tired.
And I was being difficult and didn't want to.
And I went to her mom and was like, I can't get her to go. I'm trying to do it, but she won't go with me. And her mom's like, I'll take care of this. And she goes, why don't you go show Jeff the beach? So we go and go on a little cruise. I pull over at a spot, and
he got down on his knee and proposed to me, and it definitely was the happiest moment of my life.
on the way back to tell her mom and them, it was lots of tears. And they were very happy tears from my eyes.
I'm definitely looking forward to it. I think that I'll just be thinking about how much I love him and how much we've both been looking forward to it and thinking about our life together and what's ahead and all the great memories that are to come.
I don't know. You tell yourself you don't ever see yourself being that guy or whatever, but then when it happens, you know it's right. You know that that's the person you want to be with. I never thought that I would be that person, but it happened, and I'm glad it happened with her, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with her.
I always would hear couples say that their significant other was their best friend, and I thought that was cheesy, but he really is my best friend, and now I understand there's no one else that I would rather have beside me every day, and I love him more than anything in the world, and I'm just so excited that I found him to spend the rest of my life with.
I just want her to know that I will always love her, and I will always be there for her and give her anything that I possibly can and do what's right for our family. Try to provide for her the best way I can. Just try to make her as happy as possible. All we can do.